What's up, everybody? It's your boy Imperial Custom PC. I haven't done a commentary for a little bit, so I just wanted to kind of demonstrate what a bottleneck, what it looks like, especially with the new Battlefield 2042. Sorry, I'm doing this on the fly, that's because I just got the Instagram request, because this is a quick demo just for some friends and people that have been asking for tips. I know it's not like the most professional, but I'll quickly trim it up if you find something out of it. Cool, if not, it's all good. Just wanted to let people know. Eventually I'll turn the recording into an actual video called What It's Like to Play Under a Bottleneck, the End of a Dying Era of the i5 and i7 Quad Cores. Oh yeah, shout out to my boy Desid, Spitfire, JoeyG, BroGamer, all those guys. Let me show you how to turn on DirectX 12, because it's turned off in the game. Want to go to your documents folder, you'll see this Battlefield 2042, open it up, go to settings, and then you'll see this profile save. What I would do is I would just copy this back out into the documents folder and then right click new, create a new folder, maybe call it Battlefield profile backup. So we have the original one backed up and saved, so now we can actually edit the other one. So basically you right click it, go to edit with notepad, or maybe you have a text editor. This will open up. Okay, so you're gonna want to, 0 means off, 1 means on, DX12 right here, GST, look for this one right here. Typically you'll see it on 0. You just want to type in the number 1 and then just go up here and just hit save and then back out and you're good to go. That's how you turn it on. It's that simple. I'll show you what the code is that you need to enter to get that. When you're in the game, key right here above the tab key, you hit that, it'll open up a command prompt. Perfoverlay, period, draw FPS, space, 1, 1 means on. If you want to turn it off, you just simply do the same thing and then hit 0. Enough of that, and the tips and whatnot. A lot of people new to PCs don't know this stuff, and so that's why I kind of wanted to get this out there, share a few tips. This is why I like to do these benchmarks and demos in a real world environment to show people, look, this is what happens. I'm not a kind of tech channel or tech guy that just wants to throw up a bunch of graphs on screen. Real world performance demos are just something that's more valuable, especially for me. This is proof for a client or a buyer, but that's not what you get in the multiplayer. There's way too many variables, way too much nuance. But the best way I can explain it is when you're building a PC, you want to balance everything out. So you want a strong enough CPU that can handle the GPU and vice versa. What I'm demonstrating here is the RTX 3070 bottlenecked by a CPU, which I'm calling the end of an amazing era, which was the quad cores, the i5s, even the i7s up to like the 7700K and whatnot, the 4-core, 8-thread, especially the i5s, which were just quad cores. A big misconception is a lot of people out there who may be on older hardware and aren't getting the performance they like, so they think, okay, well maybe I'll just upgrade the graphics card. However, if you do that, especially in newer games that are more optimized or geared towards highly threaded or more core count, this is what not to do, because what I'm testing right now is the i5-3570K. And the interesting thing too is I've noticed even on stock clock versus overclock testing I've done, I haven't noticed that the CPU helps in that area like it used to in terms of frame rate boost. Basically we're rocking the RTX 3070 plus the i5-3570K. Because that's the CPU got requested to see if the quad cores, how well they do, and if it would be good for a budget build. And this is why I highly advise against it if you're trying to pair it with something as powerful as an RTX card. I guess you could even do the 5500 XT. And on the NVIDIA side, you're looking 2060 Super would be the most I would even dare go. But the reason why I wanted to show the RTX is just so that people don't make that mistake of buying too much GPU. But my point is when you're on, when you're bottlenecked, you're also, it's going to eventually affect your overall performance, your muscle memory, your reaction time. I'm used to high refresh rate, high FPS, so when I'm playing on something low FPS, sometimes it, even if you're at 30 FPS or whatever it is, it may feel smooth. It may feel like you're, you know, okay, I'm doing pretty well, until you run up against somebody, let's say like Desit or something like that. Either way, the numbers don't lie because they're right here. Okay, so you're seeing on the top, it says FPS-MS. Right here, your people are like, what the heck does this mean? But what you want to focus on in red, think of it as an alert indicator. Basically what it's telling you is a CPU, this is how much FPS the CPU is able to produce. Now if you look down, the 3070 is heavily bottlenecked, so the GPU is like, oh, I'm struggling, come on, let me breathe. And the CPU is like, nah, you're good. So yeah, hopefully that makes sense, guys. So basically, to figure out what your FPS is here, we just this. The GPU is pointless because your CPU won't allow it any higher because it's the factor. It's not allowing the GPU to go any higher because, for one, it's pinged and maxed out, so it's doing all it can, meaning it's operating at 100%. You want to see the GPU at 100%. Yeah, this is what a bottleneck looks like. Here's a little bit of gameplay of it, and you'll get the term when I mean it may feel smooth, but obviously it's not. I mean, I've been playing Battlefield a long time, so I would consider myself better than a noob, being real with you. I'm just used to testing and playing at all different levels of FPS, so I just prefer a high refresh rate, high FPS. This is what a bottleneck looks like. You see, we're stuck at 30, and I obviously, when I benchmark, I do things solo because usually I'm out in the backfield running a straight line, trying to keep things duplicated for an accurate FPS demo. But for a multiplayer, you just want to just play it as it is and just show you how it performs. But running everything on low is kind of stupid because that makes it more taxing on the CPUs. And another way to get around that is maybe turning the textures up a little bit more to put more demand on the GPU to give you more FPS. So see, right now we're getting around 45, 50. That's playable, you know? And it feels smooth. It's just really not. It is what it is. Still, this shows you what a bottleneck looks like regardless. I just want to say thank you for watching. Thanks for the love of late, guys. It's been freaking insane. We've been growing pretty fast since dropping these Battlefield stuff and the Vanguard. Especially on TikTok as well. So yeah, I appreciate all the love and support. It's way motivating. Can't say thank you enough. And yeah. I'll see you in the next one. So, also, if you guys want any hardware or anything tested, or maybe even demoed, or if it's something you want to buy from me that's in my inventory and have it tested for you before you buy, let me know and I could do that too. Or any just suggestions and feedback in general would be appreciated. Make sure to smash that like button as if it owes you money, like I always say. And, obviously subscribe, come on bro, definitely subscribe. We got a lot of cool stuff coming, especially 2 years of build vlogs and mod stuff that I've been working on.
Am I a hustler? Say what? This must be the Hustler's anthem. Yeah. Who bangin'? If it start off soft, I can cook it to hard. Then hit the boulevard and drop top with a broad. I walk the green and par, push fast cars with a fetish for bank wads and Cuban cigars. Yo.